ओम श्री साई राम। चित चोरा यशोदा के माल, नवनीत चोर गोपाल। चित चोरा यशोदा के माल, नवनीत चोर गोपाल। गोपाल 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 गोवर्धन धर गोपाल गोपाल श्री साई राम। सत्य साई इज द मोस्ट वंडरफुल अवतार एवर। ही लव्स टू डू वंडरफुल थिंग्स एंड एज आई मेंशन अर्लियर इन माय टॉक्स, ही इज नॉट दैट तथास्तु टाइप ऑफ गॉड। ही इज प्रोएक्टिव। Nothing can ever happen without my intended will. He is not only our watchman, but also our catchman. Can't play around or bluff around or any tricks with this God at least. No ways. Can't outsmart him. Because he is the smartest of all. All of us put together. And he does what we cannot even think of. That is why he is God. Krishna told Arjuna. Arjuna asked him, if I had to do everything, what will you do? He said, Arjuna, I will do what you cannot do. You can't even think. I will control the wind. He will do the impossible. Because he has declared, with me, the impossible becomes I am possible. Who can imagine a God telling a devotee who wants to renounce and be with him with simple earnings and simple life? He told me that no, you don't sell any properties, you don't go there, don't do any business, you don't move from here, that's it. The rates will increase. The devotee is telling, Swami, I am not interested in big rates. I am happy with this, whatever I get. No. And when I insisted, he said, shut up. Who can argue with this God? That is why we love him. He shows he is more interested in us than we are in him. He loves us more than we can ever love him. And once we have given him our power of attorney that I have done with his grace, he takes the charge. And when he takes the charge, he takes complete charge. He told Dr. Bhagwat, when Dr. Bhagwat, our then state president of Maharashtra, great sage and noble soul, Swami, we need Harish and he needs to go and do his work there. I have changed his destiny. I am preparing him for something. And he told my good friend, whom Swami directed to me when he made me a doctor, showing my form to his mother-in-law in Taj Residency, Bangalore, that he is your doctor. And he himself was an oncologist from Greece. Great spiritual person. During my period of fire of three zeros, he got an interview and he told Swami, Swami, Harish loves you so much. Everybody writes to me about Harish loving me and all that. Nobody knows how much I love Harish. I'm preparing him for something. He said, Swami, can you do the same to me? You can't take it. That makes us humble that he shows his confidence in his donkey instruments. He made a poet out of an engineer. Never read any poem in my life. There are 2008 more than that poems. Not only that, accepting my poems in an interview through the Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sampath, putting on his lap and giving me every day one poem during darshan morning and evening, and accepting that poem from my hand, even if I'm sitting in the seventh row, he will stretch his arm to take my poem from me. And when I prayed, Swami, you should touch me, I cannot touch you because of the discipline, he would touch me and press my hand and take my poem. Morning and evening. Then he calls my son, 93, 13th of January, and tells him, your father is a doctor. I know him, he's sitting outside. And when my son said, no, Swami, he's a civil engineer. He said, no, I know him, he's a doctor. And he comes out and introduces my son to all the VIPs sitting there. Look at this boy, his father is a doctor. His mother is serving in my hospital. His grandmother is here, a very noble lady. Very good, noble family. And next day he confirms. I said, Swami, you want me to become a doctor? You are a doctor. You will become doctor to doctors. Do homeopathy. I did not know the spelling of homeopathy. In 1 month, he made me do the practice. And he invited Dr. George Vitalkos from Greece. He stayed with me in Prashanthi Nilayam. Swami spoke to him in Portico. A world-class homeopath who is personal physician to Queen Elizabeth and presidents of US, who is running his own academy to teach MD, MS doctors. And incidentally, he also is a civil engineer. He became my friend. He said, Harish, your understanding of homeopathy is just excellent. I was hardly 3 months homeopath at that point in time. Not even finished one book. And when I asked him, Swami, why you made me a doctor? He said, because you are a born psychiatrist. I see a person, I know a person. Gift of God. I don't do any meditations, you know, nothing, absolute nothing. That is how divinity works. He goes to Aurobindo Ghosh in jail in the form of Krishna. Aurobindo Ghosh wanted to serve the nation. He was a freedom fighter. Krishna told him, no, that is not your role play. You have to meditate and bring the Krishna consciousness. He said, God, but my followers are all donkeys. I can get the things done even through donkeys. Who can comprehend this wonderful God? As if he was not satisfied all with all these impossible things, he appears in my vision, which he does very often early morning during Brahma Muhurtam, anytime, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, he wakes me up. I'll have his visions, his dreams. He will instruct me, speak to me, show his vision, whatever he wants to do. I don't question him normally. He does whatever he decides to do. My only prayer to him has been, Swami, please don't listen to my prayers. You do whatever you like to do. You should never tell me, main kya kar sakta hu? Tumne bola to maine kiya. That I don't want from you. The only prayer I used to write in my poetic form as my trademark on the cover to him, and he would accept that. Make me thy child, true and pure. Pure and sure. Without any guilt, without any fear. As you are near and dear, always and everywhere. This is the only poem, prayer that I made to him. And he has been working on me for last nearly 50 years. From the very first day when I was given the book of Vivekananda during my 18th birthday in 1971 by my good friend. And the moment I read, my dears, I love you more than myself. But I want that each one of you should be prepared to die for others. That set me on fire 50 years back. I wanted to become an IAS to serve my nation. First Swami took my letter, didn't utter a word. I prepared myself for 6 months in three subjects which were not my subjects, English, psychology and law. I became master in this. I'm employed, took help of three well-known educationists to learn English. I'm from a non-English medium. To learn English, psychology and law. And after 6 months, he comes to Dharmakshetra. Hey, what are you doing? I said, Swami, I'm preparing for IAS. Why? Swami, I want to serve the nation. You can't serve the nation by becoming IAS. To SAI. IAS serve only the ministers. Do SAI. But this thought was dormant in my mind, maybe. I am not aware of it. But he works through on our subconscious mind. I would be inspired by Mahatma Gandhi's, my experiments with truth, freedom at midnight. Swami used to praise Mahatma Gandhi. He said he was Mahatma because his thought, word and actions were all one. It was a perfect coordination between his thought, word and action. Even his adversaries, he had no enemies, of course. Even his political adversaries, even the British people would trust his word. If Gandhiji has said something, it has to be true. That was his credibility. Even till today. Nobody can challenge his credibility, his honesty, his truthfulness. I wanted to live my faith like he did. And then on my 50th birthday, after the period of the fire of three zeros was over, and Swami came to give me that darshan in his golf car. I saw the live jyoti, as we call it, the lamp emerging from his heart and merging in my being. I got He had done his job. He had uplifted or enlightened after those 10 years of fire of three zeros. And then on my 50th birthday, 28th January 2003. He wakes me up from my sleep, giving me the pigeon. Hey Harish, get up. You have to do my political mission in India. You have to bring governance of God in this country. I just got up with a jerk in that sleep, half sleep. I said, Swami, please. I hate politics and politicians. Please, Swami. Hey, you must not hate any person, any situation. Hatred hardens your heart, darkens your mind. Love lightens your heart, brightens your mind. But Swami, why me? Why not you? I suggested some names. I argue with him, with his grace. I said, there are so many IAS and all qualified persons in your ashram, amongst your devotees, in your organization. I don't like to be suggested. I wanted to come out of the situation. I said, Swami, why me? I don't have any contacts. I never been to any place. Always, whenever I get a chance, I come only to Puttaparthi. I don't know anybody. I don't have any godfather. You have God as your father. Wherever you go, my people will receive you as my own. I'll speak through you, work through you, write through you. Just be my donkey instrument. I said, Swami, donkey instrument? I remembered Krishna and Aurobindo Ghosh dialogue immediately at the back of my mind. I said, Swami, why donkey instrument? In this avatar, I can get the things done only through donkeys. Because donkeys do not have any personal agenda. Now this was getting very interesting. I said, Swami, but you have... I knew a little bit of how the game of politics is being played in our country. So I wanted to put my situation, my inability to do what was expected of me. I said, Swami, you have not trained us to do this. You have not trained us to do dharnas and shoutings and criticizing and condemning. These are not our training. This is not in our Satya Sai DNA. When I decide, I provide. You will get infinite resources. I will provide. And you will achieve it without doing any criticism, any dharnas, anything. Without even raising your voice, without even raising your little finger. You will do it with my power of love. Today it is love for power. My governance will be based on power of love. Only love. My love. This was too much for me to digest. Like my son told me that Swami is by mistake thinking that you are our Chachu, means my elder brother, Dr. Prem, who has served in Swami's General Hospital. He looks exactly like me. Swami is making a mistake, but I knew this God cannot make a mistake. Even the sun may make a mistake and it may rise tomorrow from west, but this 5 feet 3 inch God, impossible. He can't make a mistake. He can make a joke. He can do fun, but not a mistake. So I wanted to reconfirm, as I did. Swami want me to become a doctor. So next day I wrote the entire conversation which I had in my dream vision. And I sat for darshan, hoping that Swami will not take my letter. So that was my prayer that if he doesn't take my letter, that means it is all over. It is a joke. And he comes, not only takes my letter. Yes. Tisko, I have Ispat Namaskar. And true to prove his point, as he did when he made me a doctor, he sends me to Delhi for the first time in my life under the pretext of my uncle telling me that there is some issues with some person in our theaters. He is a very big don and we are in mess. You please pray to Swami. And when I pray to Swami, give him a letter, मैं क्या कर सकता हूं? सोनिया गांधी के पास जाऊं. Because that point in time, the Chief Minister of Maharashtra was from Congress, Sushil Kumar Shinde, Swami's devotee. So I thought just to seek his blessings and then go to Mumbai. Swami said, go to Delhi. That was just a pretext. And when I went there, I had given details in my different talk, and I will repeat, I don't know if it was in Hindi or English. I could meet the top nine leadership of our country that point in time, including Prime Minister Vajpayee ji, Advani ji, Sonia Gandhi ji, Dr. Manmohan Singh, Shivraj Patil, Ambika Soni, Dr. Abdul Kalam, you name it, in flat 72 hours without any letter of recommendation, without any pre-appointment, just a request call to their PAs that Sai Harish Thakur from Puttaparthi wants to meet you for some. I just wanted to have that feel because Swami has given me this indication. And believe me, my dear brothers and sisters, his word, every word, wherever you go, my people will receive you as my own. I have been to Delhi after that number of times, to Gujarat to meet our present Prime Minister, then Chief Minister of Gujarat, Narendra Modi ji, even RSS Chief Mohan Bhagwat ji, every governor, every president, even West Bengal Chief Minister in 2009, Buddhacharya ji, everybody. And I could engage with them on governance of this country. They were wondering that how do you know all these things? I said, don't know, I don't know. I don't read newspapers. That point in time, I never used to look at an ashram who would read newspapers. We would turn the page, the front page. But his assurances today, with folded hands, I can say 18 years, 2003, now 2021. With his permission, I sought his permission before recording this. Not that I'm afraid of anybody, no ways. I have given this account similar to this in my talk 2014. We have a RSS Shaka in Puttaparthi. So all top leadership had come and Dr. Goel, suddenly he asked me to give a talk. And I mentioned in my talk, without any preparation, I never prepare my talks spontaneously, all this. And I said, as on today, if I stand in elections even for my own village, any village rather, my wife would not vote for me. Certainly. I have no credibility on politics. But the day Swami decides, even the top leadership will stand in queue to support his mission. That much I know. Because one with God is always in majority. And Swami has been coming to me early mornings, giving me directions for last 18 years. I have compiled it in Krishna Gita, dialogue between like Krishna and Arjuna. Many times he would appear as Krishna, sometimes in Shirdi Sai, sometimes in Satya Sai. And he has prepared me to such an extent that today, truly, honestly, practically, this child of God can bring governance of God in this country without raising my voice, without raising my little finger. And Swami clarified, governance of God means not your Rama, Krishna, or Jesus, Allah, God. God is truth, goodness, beauty. You have to bring truth, goodness, and beauty in the governance of this country. God is Satchitananda, truth, awareness, bliss. My donkey instruments will work with you, will be embodiment of, they will be real can persons. Those days I read, Barack Obama had coined this can word, capable, able, and noble. Swami said, my donkey instruments will bring about this. They will be real can persons, reliable, eligible, admirable, and lovable can persons. There will be 100% transparency and 100% accountability in governance of God. It will be governance of the good, by the good, for the good of all. No public money will be wasted on advertisements or personal securities of any person. Because Swami explained, no transparency, no accountability leads to no credibility. Today the political class has lost the credibility because there is no transparency, there is no accountability. And then Swami went on to explain, the entire book is ready. Swami has signed it, and on the 3rd of March 2011, the last interview in Purnachandra, Swami accepted the entire project and he has given the name Best of Bharat for the rest of Bharat. Look at this God. And the title of book he has given, what he told Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji and Advani ji in 1998 in Whitefield. I was present at that point in time. The future of this country, Bharat, is safe and secure in hands of Sai. Sai is Bharat Bhagya Vidhata. Title of that book Swami has given is Bharat Bhagya Vidhata. And he accepted that project, the brief, and put it on his lap on 3rd of March 2011. The last interview Swami gave to families of students in Purnachandra. They are all video recorded photographs are there. And he gave me Pad Namaskar too. He said, today there is only politics, no governance. You will bring about governance without playing politics. You will set such an example that the entire world will follow it. I remember in 1974 or 3, I believe, my room partner was Kumar Kriplani. He's now a civil engineer and of course he's a big, big, big builder in Pune and now living in Australia. My room partner. So he used to come with me to Dharamkshetra because I used to conduct bhajans in my room and do Nagarsan Kirtan in the campus alone, one man Nagarsan Kirtan. Everybody knew that. They used to call me crazy after Satya Sai Baba. So one day he was with me at the night walk and he said, Harish, what do you think? How this will change? Because situation is so bad. That time I did not even know anything about this government politics. I was just 2021. I said, this is what Swami tells me, that today we are his devotees. Tomorrow, when we marry a Bal Vikas Guru, a Sai devotee, our children will be born Bal Vikas Sai students, and their next generation will bring the change. That was 55 years before. And Swami made me say on that day, Kumar still remembers, I said, remember one thing. One day our parliament will begin with Omkar and end with Mangal Arati. I don't know why I said it, how I said it. I had no clue about it. And during 1980s, the students had formed one group like Kingdom of Satya Sai, the ex-students. They had even souvenir published 1 or 2 years. Then the Anandpur students, Kingdom of Mother Sai. Those days, one day Swami declared in portico that one day the United Nations decisions will be taken from Prashanthi Nilayam. Nobody took that seriously at that point in time. Now I know it. That is his second coming assurance. This Satya Sai. Never underestimate this God. He can get the things done even through donkeys. Whichever donkey he decides, nobody can suggest him. He doesn't like to be suggested. And there are no qualifications. Rabnu kaun aake ke yun kar aur yun na kar. Who can suggest to God what to do and what not to do? He decides, he provides. He directs, he protects. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba Ji ki Jai, Jai, Jai.